Hi, I'm Rainey, finance strategist. In this lesson, we're going to cover
valuation is a process by which analysts determine the present or expected worth of a stock, company, or asset. The purpose of valuation is to appraise a security and compare the calculated value to the current market price in order to find wise investments. While the current market price is said to reflect all variables, including irrational behavior, valuation models will only factor in a few variables. This is why there are so many different methods of valuation. This video will cover three of the most popular valuation models: the dividend discount model, the discounted cash flow model, and the capital asset pricing model. The dividend discount model, or DDM, is one of the most common valuation models. This model values a share by estimating the present value of future dividends a stock will pay. Because investors expect to earn interest on their money over time, money today is worth more than the same value paid out at a later date. This is why future payouts are discounted when computing their value today. The rate at which future dividends are discounted is known as the weighted average cost of capital. The weighted average cost of capital, or WACC, is the opportunity cost of what the investor's money could have made if it were invested elsewhere. The dividend discount model also factors in an estimated perpetual increase of the dividend payout made over time based on historical increases of the dividend payout. The present value of future dividends is equal to the estimated value of the stock. If the present value of future dividends, calculated by the DDM, is greater than the current price of the stock, then the DDM suggests it is a buying opportunity. A major limitation of the dividend discount model is that it can only be used if the company pays a dividend and the dividend returns are stable and predictable. Discounted cash flow model, or DCF, values a company based on its future cash flows discounted by the investor's expected rate of return, which is then used to calculate the stock price. The discounted cash flow model can be used even if a company doesn't pay a dividend or has unpredictable dividend returns. Using the discounted cash flow model, the enterprise value of a company is calculated by adding up the value of future earnings, then discounting the earnings by the weighted average cost of capital. Then subtract net debt from the enterprise value to compute the company's fair value and divide by the number of outstanding shares to calculate the value of a share. If the estimated value of a share using the discounted cash flow model is greater than the current value of a share, the DCF model suggests it is a buying opportunity. The weakness of this model is that it relies entirely on future cash flows estimates, which are unknown. The capital asset pricing model, or CAPM, calculates the value of a security based on expected return relative to the risk investors incur by investing in that security. To calculate the value of a stock using CAPM, multiply the volatility, known as beta, by the additional compensation for incurring risk, known as the market risk premium, then add the risk-free rate to that value. For each additional increment of risk incurred, the expected return should proportionately increase. If a security is found to have a higher return relative to the additional risk incurred, then the CAPM model suggests that it is a buying opportunity. Like all valuation models, CAPM has its limitations. Despite its shortcomings, this model is very popular for valuing securities.
For more information, visit www.financestrategist.com.